by introducing our first keynote speaker for the day. So he's also a true highlight, and I've seen that he's been starting to practice Romanian extra for you guys, so he's taking that very, very seriously. Our next speaker is Ralph Simon, and he has a very exciting job to travel the world and look for emerging digital trends that he sees everywhere that can change and impact the future. He's especially focused on mobile and as well on healthcare, so he's also a faculty member at the Singularity University. For those of you who haven't heard about the Singularity University, this has been started by two great minds, Ray Kurzweil, who's heading the Artificial Intelligence Department at Google, and Peter Diamandis, a great entrepreneur and inventor, and they only accept students in the university who have the opportunity to impact 1 billion lives with their creation. And he is a faculty member there in charge of the digital health department. He's also, his company, Mobilium Global, which he's the founder and CEO of, is doing exactly that, like traveling everywhere in the world, emerging markets, and looking for these kind of transformational technologies. And he's going to take us on a whirlwind tour on the latest trends from around the world that are hopefully going to impact all of our lives. Please give a warm welcome to Ralph Simon on stage.
Okay, okay, enough, enough. Hello, everybody. Jeez, are you dead? Is everybody still Mahmuriala? Okay, I'm so nervous. I'm very, very nervous. Am un morkov unfund. But we've got some fantastic things to show you. So let me get my machine ready here while we're just setting this up quickly. Let's just put in the special secret code, which is the Kluge code, done by Kluge coders. Very, very important. But I must tell you, this morning before I came here, I went to the coffee shop to get some tea. I like to have some tea before giving a speech. And so I was in the restaurant, and the waiter came to me, a beautiful Romanian lady from Cluj. And I said to her, I wanted to get some lemon tea. I said to her, La muie. She said to me, Mascot din pepeni. I didn't know what was going on. I thought, lemon tea. She says, no, you must not say la mouille. You must just say lemon tea. Ah, now I understand. Now I really understand. So when she said that, I thought, okay, calumia. I understand. That's good. Okay, so ladies and gentlemen, let's begin. I wanted to show you some very interesting developments that we see from all over the world. And let's go, we got our first slide up there. Okay, I'm going to take you through a journey all around the world to show you some of the really interesting trends that are starting to happen all over the world. So first of all, do you know who that is? Okay, but okay. They didn't say anything. They must have been very drunk, super saburata last night, right? Okay. Very important. Have a look at this. This gives you some idea of what's happening in the future, where a lot of what is going to be in the future will be all about artificial intelligence, AR, VR. Very, very important. It'll become like a currency, like money, because those are the things on your phone that will help you interact with modern living. And you know something? In Romania and in Cluj and in Transylvania, this is one of the most important places in the world. Why? Because here, people are very, very, very smart. Understand engineering, understand computer engineering, understand coding. Cluj is a key, key city in the future of what's happening in the modern world. So look at this. Tell me if you agree with this. What do you think? Yes? No? Yes, thumbs up. No, thumbs down. Thumbs up or thumbs down? Thumbs up. Yes. We don't have enough time. We have to do things that make life easier for us. Okay. So let's see some good examples, which we'll show you that are really interesting things. How many of you go to the gym in the morning? Oh my God. Well, let me tell you, if you live in London, the important thing to go to the gym, you can't do it when you're working, so you must do it when you're on your way to the office. Like this. Have you ever seen this? This is an interesting example. This is a mobile spinning studio that happens in London today. An aerobics gym started this bus to have a mobile workout with spinning bikes on the bus. And what happens is you get on the bus from your house and you do your exercise, your spinning, and then it drops you off at your office and you go up and you do your work. But what do you think of that idea of the future? Maybe not in Cluj, although the traffic can be bad in Cluj, but do you think it's thumbs up or thumbs down? 50-50? Yeah. M-E-H. Do you know what M-E-H is? Meh. That's what it is. Okay, let's go to the next example. The next example is somebody who is one of the genius of the future. So who is this guy? Elon Musk. Where does he come from? Exactly. Comes from Pretoria in South Africa, but now he lives in Los Angeles, and he's done some amazing things because not only did he do a rocket that goes into space and comes back again to work again, he's got the biggest lithium battery factory in the world just near Las Vegas. So if you go to Las Vegas and you go gambling, you can go to the lithium battery factory to get some more batteries to go back and do some more gambling. And then, of course, he's doing very interesting work, not just with Tesla. And the interesting thing about this is, and the reason I show you that slide, he is also somebody who is very, very keen to make sure that if you buy a Tesla, he wants to be able to be sure that you are a good customer. And there was a journalist in America that wrote a bad story about Tesla. So what he did was he decided that he was not going to give any service to that journalist's car. He switched off the computer in that journalist's Tesla because the journalist wrote a very bad story about Tesla. But look at this. Here's another picture of Elon because he's doing something else. He launched a company last year called Neuralink. Neuralink, and basically this company links the human brain with machines. Now there's going to be a very good speaker this morning by the name of Newton Howard who will show you some of the great new progress with brain interaction. But Elon is conducting research using something called neural lace, lacing together the brain, which involves putting electrodes into the brain and artificial intelligence. And the goal is to be able to have people communicate with their devices automatically. So you could just think and it goes directly to your device without any physical interface. So what do you think of that? Having your brain work your devices. Thumbs up or thumbs down? Not so good. 30% thumbs up, 70%, 50% thumbs down, 20% sleeping. Those people at the back, they're still sleeping. They haven't woken up yet. I don't know why that is. Maybe they are sugativa. Okay. So now let's have a look at something that's really a big, big change in a big city that is really something unusual. So have a look at that picture. That is in Seoul, the capital of Korea. And what you see as looks like a garden, but that was an old freeway. And when we talk about change, it's not just equipment or devices. Cities are changing. Big cities are changing. Can you imagine if in Bucharest or even here in Cluj, They had to change the road to make a fantastic garden. That was a freeway for cars, and now it's a very, very popular sky garden, similar to what happened in New York, where they took an old railway line and turned that into a garden. Now, let's go to Singapore. Here's an interesting thing. The Singapore government wanted more people to travel on the bus. So what they did was they are trying to get people not to go by car because there's too much traffic in Singapore, and they wanted people to be on the bus. So they got a special perfume, a digital perfume that is in the bus, and it's made of sandalwood. And when you get on the bus, it smells like fresh grass, like lemon or like orange and peppermint. And the idea is to make the buses feel like you are in a garden. But you must remember, when you make the perfume, it requires digital intelligence and computer technology to come up with the formula to make the perfume. Now, more people are riding in the bus because when you get on the bus, it feels like you're in the countryside. It's like you're in Brasov. Can you imagine that? You get on the bus, and there you are, in Brasov. Amazing. Okay, let's see the next one. Ah, yeah, here's an interesting thing, and this is from Colombia. In Colombia, Reebok. You know Reebok shoes? Well, Reebok liked this idea of having outdoor gymnasium at the bus stop. And if you are at the bus stop in Colombia, you can do exercises. That picture, that screen, looks at you, and if you do your exercises, when you get on the bus, you don't have to pay the ticket. The journey is for free. So this is using technology to get people to exercise, and then they can ride on the bus for free. What do you think of that? Thumbs up or thumbs down? Thumbs up. Oh, yes, that person's awake at the back there. Excellent. Very good. Okay, you like that one. That's pretty good. Okay, let's go to the next one. Here's something from Barcelona. EasyJet. How many of you know EasyJet, the airline? Now, EasyJet decided they were going to do a special project with shoes. They got smart shoes, which are synchronized with a cell phone, and it gives a special cell phone app to navigate, if you're wearing the shoes, to your destination. It's developed by EasyJet with Google Maps and an API, and it uses a vibration module inside the shoe with a battery and a miniature Bluetooth low-energy unit inside each shoe and a buzz in the heel, bzzz, like that. It tells you when you're making the right turn, one buzz for the right turn and two buzzes if you make the wrong turn. So this is an interesting way for your shoes, and it gives you three buzzes when you reach the final good destination. When you use Google Maps, do you sometimes find difficulty knowing if you must turn to your left or turn to your right? Yes, yes, there's that lady there. She has a big problem. If you wore these shoes, you'll get three buzzes tell you, yes, I've arrived. I'm here at Texelvania. Three buzzes. Good idea. Not a bad idea. Okay, let's go to the next one. This is a very interesting project. Google Experimental Labs in Silicon Valley, working with Levi's jeans. But what they did was they created a special material that's got a special fiber inside the material. When you touch the material, it can make your phone work. The material is tactile. It's touch sensitive, specially designed for people on bicycles, and the jacket allows people to connect with their cell phone by touching their sleeve just like that, and controlling music, controlling calls on the phone, or finding out directions to nearby places. It's called Levi's Commuter X, and it's being tested and will be released in a couple of months. So this is quite an interesting thing, and people who see this, they look at Levi's and they say, Schmeckere! That's what they say. Okay, let's go to the next one. This is very interesting. Amazon have added free fashion advice service as a mobile app for its members in America, and this it compares the it's called Outfit Compare. Outfit Compare, see the name at the top. With it gets shoppers to upload two photographs of yourself in different clothes with an Amazon stylist that responds immediately on your phone, and it shows a picture of you with new clothes to help you choose to buy something. So you send Amazon two photographs, and then from that moment, you say, I want a summer dress. I want a winter coat. It immediately changes the look of you on your phone from Amazon. What do you think of that idea? Thumbs up or thumbs down? About 60-40, 60 up, 40 down. Okay, well, let's have a look. Let's just see what, let's see how this works. You know, they say in Romania, pace din rahat bici, right? But this is a different story, because now let's have a look at another interesting thing. In Japan, here's an interesting idea from Japan. This is in Japan, there's a beauty cosmetic company called Shiseido. And Shiseido uses face recognition technology to determine your smile. And basically, you look at a mirror with this app in it, and it gives you a rating of your smile, and it helps to decide what cosmetics you can use. So it's an interesting way for a cosmetic company to take technology and use it in an interesting way, and also for the airline, Japan Airlines, using this where their staff on the planes can see whether they look okay for the customers. Not a bad idea. Okay, let's have a look at the next one. Here we are, something from Prague. Very interesting. This is in the subway in Prague. Now that looks like a shop. That looks like a supermercado, a supermarket. But it's not. It's virtual. What you see there is just virtual, but you tap your phone on that, and then those goods will be delivered to your house. So in Japan, if you go to the subway, you can see a full wall. You just point your phone at the wall and you buy the products from your phone on the wall, and in 2 hours, the products are delivered to your apartment. What do you think of that idea? Thumbs up or thumbs down? Thumbs up. Not a bad idea. That's right. Exactly. Very, very good. Mente creativa. Very good. Okay. Let's look at the next one. Here's an interesting idea from Paris. Citroën, the motor car company, and Le Coq Sportif clothing company have created two mobile bicycle workshops to celebrate the 70th anniversary of a Citroën H van. Each workshop is built inside a van and it's painted with the Coq Sportif brand. And these vans are set up all over Paris because lots of people are riding on bikes, but you want to get your bike repaired. How do you do it? So Citroën and Le Coq Sportif doing something interesting in the city, which brings a service to people that are living in the city. So in that way, the French people won't lose their temper, and il sare mustaru. I think that's the way that you say it here in Romania. Let's look at the next one. Ah, here's an interesting idea. How about if you've got a dog in your apartment, but this is a self-cleaning system that provides the dogs with an indoor toilet and then cleans it, and then you don't have to take the dog out for a walk. It's incredible. The dog can just sit on that pad, and the pad dries out solid waste, dog matter, and takes liquids and wraps it up to prevent the smell. And then a motor also replaces the pads with fresh ones. And you only need to empty it out once every few weeks. So this is an interesting idea, and it only costs $230, but it allows small dogs to do their thing in the apartment, and you don't have to take the dog for a walk. So isn't that great? You can have a dog, but you don't have to take the dog for a walk. Thumbs up or thumbs down? Woo, woo, woo. Very good. Very good. So that's a good idea, no? Okay, let's go to the next one. I didn't hear anybody saying Beton or Marfa. Is that Marfa or not? Or is it Naspa? Marfa. It is. It's Marfa. That's my man. Yeah. Okay. So how many of you have a refrigerator in your apartment? Everybody. But how many of you can do this? How many of you can order your groceries from your refrigerator? So don't you think this is an interesting idea from Samsung, released last year in Korea and now starting to spread all over the world, where you can go to your refrigerator, or your refrigerator tells you, milk, we need some milk, or we need some cheese, or we need some food, and then you just press the door of the refrigerator and you can order the groceries. They'll be delivered within one day. Thumbs up or thumbs down? What do you think? Thumbs up. Pretty good. Yes. Very good. That's a good one. That is a good one. And I know Romanians, vinde gogosh. They don't lie. This is what they like. Very good. Okay, let's go to the next one. Ah, how many of you like eating salad? Good, healthy salads. Just three people. Not beer, not whiskey, but salad. Here's an interesting idea. Check this out. This is Chowbotics, and this is a special chef in a machine that creates salads. It's a small, the size of a small refrigerator, and it creates over 1,000 types of different salads from 21 ingredients, and can make a salad in 1 minute, faster than a human. It's available, just come out in April. It can be purchased for, in America, $500 a month, but it makes up to 1,000 different kinds of salads from 21 ingredients. It's a sign of the future. It might be expensive now, but this is something that's going to have a lot of appeal in the future. Can you imagine if you come home and you say, I want an avocado salad with beans and with lettuce. Boom, you press the button, and within a minute, you've got the salad. What do you think? Thumbs up, thumbs down? Oh, my God. Thumbs down. People didn't like that idea. Well, includes, you get fresh vegetables, and you want to make the salad yourself. But that's not a bad idea. Think about it. In the future, if you're very, very, very busy doing computer engineering, you don't have time to think about the salad. And here's a good example that you can use. Okay, here's another very interesting one. You know, how much food in a supermarket or how much food in your house do you not eat that goes to waste? A lot, 40%. 40% of all food that is purchased goes to waste. So here's something interesting. In a Japanese store, the price comes down before the product date comes up. So what this means is the platform uses real-time product tracking to reduce the price of goods when their sell-by date. I don't know how you say in Romanian, sell-by date, the date when you've got to sell the product. But this aims to reduce the food waste. $57 billion is the amount of food waste each year by the grocery industry. And this system uses radio frequency ID, dynamic pricing, and basically helps to reduce the price. So let's say you go to a store and you've got yogurt, and it's only got 2 days left before the date, it'll be much cheaper than if you bought it last week. So not a bad idea. Okay, let's go to the next one. This is looking at mobile phones, and this is something in America where, because a lot of fraud, the bank will take a photograph of your eyeball, and your eyeball will be your ID, so that you will basically call up your bank on your phone. It'll take a photograph of your eye that goes to the bank's computer, And then the bank will give approval for you to withdraw money that is sent directly to your phone. So this is ID, E-Y-E, ID, ID, no, I-ID, wait, I-D, I-ID, I-ID. What do you think? A good idea for I-ID? Thumbs up or thumbs down? Thumbs down, thumbs up. That girl's got her leg up. Hey, what are you doing in the back there with that boy? Just a little joke there. It's too early in the morning for that kind of joke. Okay. Here's a good one. MasterCard, in South Africa, there is a lot of corruption with a lot of people committing fraud and stealing from banks. So now, on a credit card, you can have your fingerprint on the credit card, and that will be the authorization. So here is MasterCard. It requires a fingerprint on the card in the machine to give the purchase, and it's working very, very effectively in South Africa. It's a biometric credit card. It verifies your identity with a fingerprint, and this works in supermarkets, and it's special fingerprint scanning technology. And the customer just gives the card to the shop with the finger on the card, and that gives the approval. So not a bad idea. Thumb. That, oh, you want to use the thumb? That's right. That's right. You're using the thumb. Exactly. That's exactly right. Okay, let's go to the next one. What is this one here? Ah, here's something interesting. This is a London-based company called Curve, K-E-R-V, and this gives you a special ring, and this ring allows you to pay for items without using your credit card or a bank card. You go to the shop, and you just have your ring like that, and you can pay for all of your goods. It's like this ring here. My wife sees this ring, and she goes to the dress shop, and she just uses this ring to pay for all of her dresses. Not really. Maybe sometimes she does. But what do you think of that idea? A ring, not a credit card, to pay, give you that possibility. Not too bad. It only costs £99, quite a lot, 450 lei, but it can be switched off to prevent unauthorized payments. It never needs to be charged, and it doesn't need to sync with a smartphone. So it's a Curve wearable bank-connected ring. Okay, let's go to the next one. How many men here in the audience sometimes worry that your deodorant under your arms is not smelling good when you want to impress your girlfriend, but you're worried you might be smelling? How can you tell if you are smelling or you are not smelling? Does anybody know? How about if you used your mobile phone? Look at that. The smartphone automatically detects if there's a smell. So before you see your girlfriend, you just go like this. The phone says, you're okay. Everything is going to be just fine. Super. Everything will be great. Sunt kotoi batrin. What do you think of that idea? Thumbs up, hands down. Very good. Okay, let's go to the next one. What's this one here? Stuttering. I don't know how you say Romanian for stuttering. What would the word for stuttering be in Romanian? Say again. You know what I mean. So stuttering is a very, very difficult issue for younger people. And here is a telco, Vodafone, that have a special app that helps young people with stuttering. Very important. Even though it's a small percentage of people, stuttering is a big problem. And many people take many years to overcome stuttering. You know, just this week, Helmut Kohl, the former German chancellor, died. He was the chancellor for 18 years. When he was a young man, he stuttered all the time. He never had that app. But here's something from Vodafone, which is an interesting piece of new technology. Okay, let's have a look at this next one here. This is special customized luggage. We're looking at traveling and things to do with traveling around the world. And this company allows customers to support social causes. Let's say you want to support an orphanage or you want to support some social cause, and you can choose 12 emojis, like, for example, girl power, stay awake, and they can be hand-painted onto any suitcase in the collection. It's done in conjunction with a famous American artist, and 10% of the profits from the suitcases goes to a charity, but you can basically get a bag or a suitcase made with your social message. Very important in the sharing economy for there to be a social message. Now, here in Cluj, it's such a beautiful city with such incredible buildings, and some people say there's too much graffiti and the buildings need to be painted. But look what the Italian government have just decided just a few weeks ago. The Italian government have got a promotion where they will give you a castle for free across the country. Castles, towers, monasteries, and the buildings are being given away for free to people who will take on the responsibility to renovate those buildings and help boost local tourism. It's a special program on mobile phones from the Italian tourism. It's called the Italy Strategic Tourism Plan to encourage tourists to visit new areas. So can you imagine if here in Cluj, they decided to give away the church in the square for free? Not a bad idea to fix it up. Or for example, the Modern Museum of Art. I went there last night. I was shocked. Someone should get some paint to make it look. It's such an incredible building. Don't you think if they gave that one of those buildings to someone here where you could fix it up, don't you think that's a good idea? Thumbs up or thumbs down? Yeah, thumbs up. Cluj, such an important city. We've got to make it more beautiful. Exactly. Okay, let's go to the next one. What is this one here? Who has not played Pokemon Go? Oh my God, what do you do at night? Are you making love with your boyfriend or your girlfriend all the time? Pokemon Go is very important because it really helped to broaden virtual reality in a way that hadn't happened before. Developed in America by Niantic, a game engine company, and of course Pokemon in Japan, but very, very important. And it led to an interesting thing. In London, the most important dress shop in London, look what they created. If you are in London, in the store, you can put on an Oculus Rift headset, and effectively, you will have a free virtual water slide experience inside the shop. You put on the Oculus Rift to enjoy the splash experience, and it shows you sliding down Oxford Street, the main street in London, in an inflatable device, and you do this inside the store, and it's something that has become incredibly popular. So people going to buy clothes put on the headset and have this experience. What do you think of this inside a retail shop? Good idea? Thumbs down. Yeah, not so good. Well, maybe if you try it, next time you go to London, go to Topshop at Oxford Circus. It's very interesting. Okay, how many of you in the audience have not smoked marijuana? All of you have never smoked marijuana. How many of you have never had ecstasy before? All of you, my God, what incredible people. So anyway, now you know cannabis, marijuana is now legal in 20 states in America. And now there's an explosion in people trying to create products with marijuana. You think, marijuana, you can make money with marijuana. You must be high just thinking about it. No, not true. Well, this is the company, let's have a look. This is a special brand of cannabis where products for social consumption, like for example, people with cancer that need to take cannabis products. And you know, there are two well-known people that have started a special cannabis brand, the Bob Marley brand and the Snoop Dogg brand. They are selling cannabis Snoop Dogg. So if you go to Colorado or to California and you want cannabis, Which would you prefer, Snoop Dogg or Bob Marley? What about you? Bob Marley. See that lady there knows? She's Bob Marley. She wants to be jamming. Okay, let's go to the next one. What's this here? Ah, fantastic. From Malaysia. A lot of problems with mosquitoes and dengue fever and malaria. Here is an interesting umbrella. You put the little connection on top of the umbrella, and what this does is it's called rain sprout. You put on top of the umbrella, and it's got a special poison that mixes with rainwater, and it kills the mosquito eggs that can infect people. It's been very popular. It's started by a telecommunications company, and Telecom Malaysia donated that for people to put on umbrellas. It's a pretty good idea in very hot tropical countries where you have to worry about mosquitoes. So what do you think of that? Thumbs up, thumbs down. Thumbs up, pretty good, interesting idea. Okay, let's go to this next one. How many of you like robotics, robots? One, two, few, not many, more. So robotics is a very, very important area. Some of the new robotics are just incredible and also are going to play a very important role in hospitals, in homes for old people, for sick people, because robots are becoming more and more like humans, where you can speak to them, and also the doctor can be in Bucharest speaking to somebody in Cluj through the robot, and it feels like it's a human speaking. So this is a robot that is a home manager, a security guard, a family photographer, and it operates on voice command. It navigates on its own wheels. It can respond to questions, connect with smart home devices, and entertain children with songs and cartoons. It's really interesting. It costs just, in America, $600, and it could be very, very useful. And just to give you an idea, it's similar to this, which is helping old people or elderly people from not being lonely. One of the biggest problems with people getting older who do not know about the internet is that they get lonely. So now you can also get VR headset, which helps elderly people not being lonely. This is an important new area for dealing with people that are getting older now that we are living longer. Now, if you are healthy and you eat healthy food and you do exercise, you can live to be 1,260 months. Wouldn't you like to be 1,260 months? Do you know how many years that is? 1,260 months. How old is that? 105. I'm going to be 105 at my next birthday. I'm 104, but since I've been in Cluj, I now know I'm going to be living for one more year at least, because being here is such a good tonic for my soul. I love it. Very, very good, because I don't feel varza. I feel good. That's right. Very good. Okay, just the last few slides. Look at this. Here's a Ukrainian company. They've developed slides, solar panel blinds for the windows that automatically adjust and follow the sun. They collect the maximum amount of energy and they change their position. So this is a new development that looks at solar but puts it into window blinds that help close when the sun is shining too hot. This actually is a pretty good idea. It's beton. Let's have a look at the next one. Here, looking at solar power and power. Let's just go back. Can we just go back, Claudia? Claudio? Where are we? Can we just get our slide back? There we are. That's it. So look at this. This is a sidewalk with special solar panels. And these solar panels, it's a bike lane. It's a material that takes out the pollution from the air. And this is installed in a Spanish city. And it's called Ecogranic It cleans up 50% of nitrogen oxide in the air with a reaction with sunlight, and the toxins then get washed away by the rain. And this is guaranteed for 25 years, but it helps keep pollution from the cities. So imagine if this was in Cluj, this would be a really great thing. And now the last few slides I want to show you. How many of you like fast cars? Fast motor cars, like the ones that we saw outside here today? Well, check this out. Here is a China-created car. it goes from 0 to 200 kilometers an hour in 7 seconds. Top speed, 300 kilometers an hour. It's completely electric, completely electric. Made in China, so this is a very interesting one to watch. Here's another super electric car. This was just came out last month at the Geneva Motor Show. Made in Singapore by Vanda Electronics with Williams, the car racing company. And this goes up to 200 miles an hour, 300 kilometers an hour, 320 kilometers. And how much do you think this car will cost if you want to buy this electric car? How much? Say again. Any more? 100,000, 200,000, $1 million. $1 million. Who in this audience would like to buy the car? We'll take the fingerprint credit card and you can buy it. $1 million, but we'll come down because electric cars are going to definitely become more important. Let's just, we'll miss that one there, we'll miss that one, we'll miss that one. Here's an interesting one, our last couple of slides. Let me just, you know, now all over the world, many countries allow same-sex marriage. Men can marry men, women can marry women, maybe not in Romania, but, you know, it's important. If you fall in love with somebody and you want to marry them, it doesn't matter who they are. Look, Michael Jackson fell in love with his monkey, but he wasn't allowed to marry the monkey. But anyway, here's an interesting thing. There's certain countries, like in Taiwan, you're not allowed to get married to who you want. But here is a bank, HSBC, the bank, got the CEO of the bank to walk down the aisle in the church with this woman at her wedding. She'd been with her partner, another woman, for 11 years, but her father didn't like the relationship. In Taiwan, you can't have that kind of relationship. And so this wedding was attended by HSBC, the bank, and the bank published a video which went viral in Taiwan, but it just showed that here was a bank that was helping to work with its customers in an unusual way. So, in a similar theme, here in China, last two slides, here's a metro system. It encourages commuters to share their romantic feelings. It's a special pink carriage. This is basically where, if you sit in this carriage, you sit in, it's like Tinder, but on a commuter subway. If you sit in this carriage, you can go up to somebody and say, would you like a date? It's called the Shenzhen metro system in Shenzhen, and it's available for 1 month. And finally, our last slide is something I want to ask you all a question. And the question is, how many of you would take all of your clothes off, would take all of your clothes off and go naked to get free groceries? Would you do that? That guy would. He's got such an incredible body. So here we are. Now, this actually did happen. Would you do this for free groceries? Here in Germany, of course, only in Germany would they do this. They love not wearing their clothes in Germany. But here, a German supermarket, free groceries for naked shoppers, a special promotion. Thumbs up, actually, I don't know if it's thumbs up, something else up. Thumbs up or thumbs down for shopping naked for your groceries. What do you think? Yes, he would definitely do it. You have done it. That's you. Oh my God. He did that. Well, so ladies and gentlemen, all I can say is thank you so much. I hope that you enjoyed some of these ideas because for me, Romania is very, very, very important. And Cluj, oh my God, I love this place so much. If I could find a wife from Cluj, I would get married this afternoon. So thank you. My name is Ralph Simon. Thank you.
Okay. Good. You're staying for the party tonight, so we'll find you a wife tonight. So if there's any volunteers, this young gentleman is still available and stays with us in Cluj then. Thank you so much, Ralph.
Thank you.
And I could definitely need the odor detector, because by going overtime, you definitely make me sweat. So I definitely want to know.
Oh, good. Like, you need that detector. Very good. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. It was a fantastic show.